Hello, this is going to be a video showing you a new bayonet. I say new, it's not brand new, but it is the one that I believe is still currently used by British troops. This is the SA80 bayonet. Comes with like an anti-reflective coating on it, which is quite nice. This has a little button here with a catch mechanism, because this would actually fit onto the barrel of the rifle, so it could be fired while this is attached. And here's the part that looks a little strange, because you've got the hole here that goes all the way through the handle, so the blade is not actually central with the handle, it's off to the side. And I was wondering whether that would be a little strange, but it's not too bad. I've chopped down a 1-inch limb of a bush with this today, beaten the hell out of a big box, cardboard box. I have had to reprofile the edge and then sharpen it, because it wasn't really all that sharp. And it had a few little dings in it from, I guess, training, or who knows if it was used on anybody. But it generally came in really good condition. And it came with the rigid, scabbard. But it's the stripped down one that's issued to reserve troops. So it doesn't have like the saw on it. It doesn't have the wire cutter, it doesn't have the sharpening stone, which would probably be connected around here somewhere. I'm thinking of getting the wire cutter one, just because that might be handy, because that has a little peg that sticks up, and you put the knife hole over that, and you kind of twist it like that to be able to use this side of the blade in order to cut wire. So I think just for like a survival-y type thing, that might be nice to have. It'll cost me another 20 something pounds to just acquire this part alone, just for the wire cutting. But it also comes with an outer sheath. This is what they refer to as a frog. So this is the old pattern, DPM. It's not the current camouflage, but who knows, maybe I'll get a different one. So this, the actual scabbard, fits inside here. And there's a clip here that clips into that. So that when you pull the blade out, the bayonet, it kind of stops this whole thing from coming out. So the blade, the bayonet, only goes in one way, so you have to have like the flat side on the edge going first. So that's how it would be. You've got a couple of different options to put it on a belt. These are special types of snaps. They're usually referred to as dot or one way. These say one way. And what that means is there's a special piece in here. Not sure if you'll be able to see this or not. There's like a little ramp on there. So what this is if you are pulling it, you pull it from the non-ramp side like this, and that will allow it to pull off. But while it's attached and force is going on it like this, it can't actually unpop, because it has to be unpopped like this. And when you pop it back on, so you're like attaching it to a belt, you have to attach it like this, like in reverse order. If you were to try and press this down just to snap it on like a regular kind of snap, you'll damage these little ramps, and it will make it ineffectual. So you'll end up with just a normal snap that might just pop off your belt when you're using it. So there you go. It's a nice bladed article. This part is supposed to be sharpened, So I've sharpened it very similar to what my K-bar USMC knife is. It has a very, very, very good point on it, because of course the primary purpose of a bayonet is to plunge into someone's chest through clothing and whatnot in the army or the various military divisions. And I've seen the actual training thing for this, the little written pamphlet thing, and it says the top part is not supposed to be sharpened, because if you do, it will hamper its ability to spread apart ribs when you plunge it in. Apparently the ribs will get like caught up. So maybe that's too much information for you, but it's the fact. So obviously I'm using it as like a general purpose knife, but it's just cool because I've now got a really old one and now I've got a really new one. So but obviously this has more general utility to it because it is a knife, but it's also a bayonet. Whereas the other one from 1890, it's just a bayonet. It doesn't have any kind of sharpness to it. It has no general purpose utility, whereas this is excellent. So there you go. I may buy another one of these in time, just to keep it as it comes. But for now, this one's for actual just making use of. So whether or not I've got my K-bar or this, I can chop things and cut things and do what I need to do. And it's good to go. So obviously I won't need that. Looks slightly rusty. Might do something about that somehow. I don't know. There you go. Please like, subscribe, and I will see you on whatever the next video happens to be about. Thank you.